So the slides you have seen was created by an AI completely for free. So to start creating these kind of slides, all you need is to come to your browser. You can type Google if you want. You can come to slidesai.io. Okay, so this website, you can see create presentation slides with AI in seconds. Okay, so you can just go ahead and click on this, and it's going to bring you over here. So create presentation slide with AI in seconds. Say goodbye to tedious manual slides creation. Let the AI create professional engaging slide from any text in no time. Okay, so either from your own text or from the kind of text you prompted, it's going to install for you directly. So all you need is to install this as a plugin or as an extension to your Chrome browser, and it's going to add it to your Google Docs file or slides file. Okay, so all you need is come over here or here, you just install the AI for Google Slides. So you just click and it's going to prompt you to open to install it with one of your accounts. You can go ahead and say install, and you're going to select one of your accounts, or you can go ahead and install it directly from any of your account. It's just a step-by-step process, and I'm going to install on one of my Google accounts and I'll meet you at the other side. So once you finish installing, you can just come to docs.google.com over here, or you can come to slides.google.com just like so, and you'll be prompted to this place. Okay, this is your Google Slides, and you can just go ahead and click on a blank sheet just to start a presentation. And you can go ahead and come over here, name the presentation. For example, let's say we are going to make a presentation about climate change. Now we can go ahead and come to the extension over here, because what we have added is an extension in Google Docs or in Google Slides. So you can see the extension over here, slideai.io, just create slides with AI. You can come ahead and say you can write with magic write. You can create slide with magic write, or you can go ahead and generate this slide directly. So let's say we want to generate slides. Now we have a bunch of options to start with over here. The first thing is you can start with your own text. If you have a text, you can paste it over here, and it's going to create this slide for you directly with just one click, and everything is going to be made very professionally and even something that you can simulate quite fast. And if you don't have your own text, you can go ahead and say you want to start creating the slide from a topic. Maybe you just have a topic and you want the AI to create the slides for you. So you can go ahead and type the topic over here. Let's say we want to talk about climate change, like I said. Now climate change, you have to specify how many slides, number of slides that you want. You can start from 8 to 9 to 10 slides, however you want it. And then you can give additional information if you are interested in additional information. You can define the theme if you are interested. You can come over here, define the theme. What kind of theme do you want? You can see from the range of themes that we have, this is a default theme. But if you want, you can select another theme and you can preview each theme if you are interested. For example, this one, you can see the theme, you can see the samples of presentation. You can just go ahead and just scroll around to just have a look at them and then see how you're going to kind of arrange your own theme or your own slides. Okay, so you can see for now, let's say we go with the default theme, which is the first one over here. I think I kind of like it, so we can go with it. And then let's go back to our text, and then you can specify whether to add an image or not. If you want the presentation to include images, you can just click on this and it's going to add images for you. Now once you finish starting with all this, you can just go ahead and say create slides, and in just a matter of seconds it's going to create that slide for you. So in case if you are interested in adding more images, maybe the images that it has given you may not be too relevant to what you are doing or what you want, you can always use the magic write to add other images or to import other images from other sources, so you can add to your presentation and make it much more tasty and professional. So I'll show you in a bit how to add more text if you're interested. Alright, so right now the presentation has been created. You can see your slides have been created, however it could take up to 30 seconds to load. Okay, so you can just give some seconds to load. You can find your input text in the speaker notes, okay, of the first slide. You can check the speaker notes and you're going to find some text if you're interested. Please feel free to close this this model, so you can close. If you want to add other, you can search or replace images with AI suggested images from magic write. So you can say open magic write from here if you are interested. Now it's telling you that you can find magic write in the sidebar, so you can close this. Now everything is done. Now this is the slide it has created for us. The first is this one. This is the first slide, understanding climate change, and then you can see the content. You can see this one, what is climate change, and it has given you 2 points, clearly written and very professional. You can see this one, evidence of climate change. I think the images are quite good, but not so good, but we can still find more relevance to it. Impacts of climate change. You can see this is what can we do, and then it gives you 2 suggestions there about. And then this is just 7 slides. Let's say we go with this, and we have our magic right in cases if you want to add anything, paraphrase a tense sentence, recommend images, or share your feedback. You can do all that with magic right. Okay, so let's say we want to recommend images. So let's see some suggested images from here. So it is reading the slide text, so it is going to recommend some images for us. Okay, so you can see now, based on the slides that you've given, it is now recommending some images that you can use to add to your content. So let's say we just move around and see which one is relevant on your own. You can see this one is very relevant because it's among the causes of climate change. So you can just select on it. Okay, so you can just select, use this, and it's going to add it to your presentation just like so. Oh, you have to select a shape to add. Okay, so let's say we come over here, select a shape. Okay, let's say we go with something like this shape, and then we want it to add it, use this, and it's going to add it in this very shape. All right, so you can see right now it has added it in this shape. Let's try to see if we can maximize the sizing, or we can double click and resize it. So once you double click, you can resize the image so it is visible like this. So you can click out, and you can see now this is good. Now if you don't want something like this, you can still come back to magic right. Instead of suggested images, you can search for images on your own. Let's say we search for images like solar system or solar panels. You can just search directly, and maybe we can take something like this in this shape. All right, you can take something like this, or we can take something like this. And I think this one looks fantastic and nice. If you're interested, I think you can just double click and just bring the back down the wind vane a little bit so that it can just become visible. So you click out, and then you can do the same for all the other slides. If you think that these slides are not what is climate change, I think this image is portraying enough. If you want to change any, you can just select this one. For example, I want to change this, and maybe we can replace it with something like evidence of climate change. So you can come over and search. Maybe you can just search evidence of climate change. Right. So magic right is very, very useful, and it can give you fantastic suggestions that you can easily use on your own. If you don't have what you need, you can just go ahead and continue to just search for something like pollution. You can see different kind of things. And let's say we go with something like this, and it's going to replace the image that you have here. All right, so this is good. So we can do the same for all the other slides. Impacts of climate change. So you can just go ahead and see what are some of the impacts of climate change. You can pick on any, and just to showcase something that this climate change can affect things like this guy that is living peacefully, but it can affect his life as well. So it's going to add it to this very slide that we have, even though this striking also is evident enough. All right, so you can double click and you can resize this. Okay, it becomes fully visible. All right, so this is it. So you can do the same for all the other slides, and you can use the suggestion very nicely, and you can you're free to go ahead and click out to close. And if you're interested, you can even select from the range of themes that we have over here. If you're not interested in the other themes that you have, you can always select another theme, and all your presentation is going to be converted to this very theme. You can see with just one click, everything has been converted to just this theme. So you can go ahead and select and create or edit the text accordingly. So this is how fantastic it is to create very simple and professional slides for your content creation, or for your next seminar or your next presentation. So you can always use the presenter view. You can come to slideshow and click on this, and you can use the presenter view. So what this means is, as you're presenting, as a presenter, you'll be able to have some notes that you can always have a look at. So you can see, you can now go ahead and start presenting, and you'll be able to see the presentation going gradually. You can move from slide to slide, okay, very nicely. You can see from the slide notes, you can have evidence tools if you have, and speaker notes. In case if you have any notes, you can always write them. You can always write them and you see them over here, okay? These are where you will find your notes. So you can close on this, for example, and you can escape this. And you can come down here, just extend, and you can add your speaker notes over here, whatever you want to add. So whatever you want to add, once you start the presentation, you can go to presenter view and you can see presenter view, and it's going to start from that particular slide that you're working on. And you can see this is the speaker notes that you have, we've created. So you can add as many speaker notes as you want, and then you can always use this because the people you are presenting to will not see this. It's only you that will be able to see this, okay? So this is just a bit about how to use the slideai.io to create stunning presentations with Google Slides. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in the next one. Bye.